Hi, and welcome back to our masterclass on data governance from AWS. I'm Kevin Lewis, and today we're going to talk about business alignment and really getting started on the right foot with your data governance program. And I will tell you, this is by far the most important topic strategically for any data governance program. I will tell you that this one specific piece of advice can save you 2 years of struggle easily. I know that's a lot to promise, but I'm going to share with you a subtle difference between the right way and the wrong way to get a data governance program started that will make a very, very big difference in the way you approach this and in the success that you have with your program. If you get this one thing right, everything else is details. All right, everything else will work itself out, but this is the thing you have to get right. And what I will tell you is, if a customer is reaching out and they're saying, hey, I'm having struggles with my data governance program, can you come and help? I can tell you with about a 90% certainty that this is the mistake that's occurring because it is so common. I've seen it so many times over the years. So what is it? What is it that that companies are doing wrong when they get the data governance program started? And the problem is this: it's making a business case for data governance. That's the problem. I know that sounds like the right thing to do, but actually it gets organizations into trouble. And this is what I mean by a subtle difference between the wrong way and the right way to do it. So it's not so much that building a business case for data governance is itself incorrect, it's how it's done. So what we'll see over and over again is proposing the value of data governance on its own. So we'll talk about things like making it easy for people to find the data that they need. We'll talk about improving data quality. We'll talk about developing a single source of truth, defining key metrics, and we'll try to put some business value around these things. And that sounds good. In fact, you're going to find this kind of advice very commonly. If you were to look for articles and books and so on, this is the kind of advice that you'll get. But it really gets a company into trouble, and I'll explain why. It's because what you're going to end up doing is competing with the very initiatives that you should be supporting, okay? So instead of proposing the value of data governance on its own, we need to work backwards from the business initiatives of the organization. Now, really, it's about finding someone else's business initiative to support. We've talked about things like customer experience, or we can think about supply chain optimization, for example. And what you're going to find is that there are already big, huge business initiatives in your organization, and just about every, if not every, major business initiative requires data to be successful. If you can position the data governance program to be like a load-bearing wall, like in construction, they call it a load-bearing wall, that without it, the house crumbles. Okay, the house is the business initiative and data governance is the load-bearing wall. If you can position data governance as a load-bearing wall within the company's major business initiatives, then it's going to be successful. Again, this is a very subtle difference. They're both making a business case. One is making a business case for data governance on its own and the business value around it, and another is making a business case for how data governance can support the major business initiatives of the organization. So then what we're going to do in order to drive data governance is we're going to get an understanding of which data is needed for the targeted initiatives. What is the condition of the data underneath those targeted initiatives? And then we're going to talk about what do we need to do to get the data in the right condition to meet the needs of those specific initiatives. This sounds deceptively simple, but I promise you that this is the mistake that's happening in many, many organizations. Again, 90% of the time, if a company is struggling with their data governance program, this is the problem that they're having. So which business initiatives do we support? We want to look for funded business initiatives or initiatives that are very likely to be funded. Let me tell you a story about this and just how subtle it can get. So we were working for an automotive company. We were helping them with their overall data strategy, and data governance was one piece of this program. And we were meeting with a business executive from the marketing area. And this marketing executive was proposing a particular use case that we could support with this data strategy. And it's not terribly important what the details are. It had something to do with linking warranty inquiries with the marketing process, something along those lines. And this executive presented some very impressive numbers about what could be done if we were to support this business initiative with the data strategy that we were helping to formulate. So here we have a business executive with very strong sponsorship. We have very significant ROI, and they are proposing to drive at least use this as one element to drive the overall data strategy. And yet it would have been a huge mistake to support this. And why would I say something like that? Because he sort of let slip out that, hey, I have been proposing this initiative for the last 3 years and I can't get any funding for it. So I'm so glad you're here with funding for this data governance program within this data strategy that you're doing. So now I can finally get this work done. That's not a business initiative we want to support, because there are going to be a wonderful idea and lots of return on investment, but we want to support the business initiatives that are funded based on their own merit, because all of those initiatives are going to require data for success. Now, there's nothing wrong with working with the business to brainstorm and formulate new ideas. Okay, this is fine. This is great. But those things need to be funded based on their own merit, not because you got a big bucket of funding for a data strategy or a data governance program. So this is what I mean by subtlety. But if you get this subtlety right, everything will cascade from this point. Everything we're going to talk about will cascade from the fact that you are supporting business initiatives that are funded outside of the data governance program, and you are positioning the data governance to show how they will succeed. Now, we talked in the last video about also looking across business initiatives. So it's not about getting too closely aligned with any one business initiative. But if you do this over and over again with multiple business initiatives, you're going to find data reuse opportunities. You're going to find opportunities to integrate data. And it's going to drive the priorities of the work that you need to do in partnership between IT and the business to position the data to meet the needs of these business initiatives. And with everything that you do, every action that you take is going to do basically two things. It's going to provide near-term business value, because by definition, you're supporting the most important business initiatives of the company. But you're also incrementally improving your data resource as a whole every time you deliver business value. So it's targeting business initiatives and it's improving the data resources. But the prioritization is based on the near-term success of the business initiatives that you'll target. And finally, on this, we get all kinds of questions, and very often they'll come right back to the same answer. How do I get funding for the data governance program? How do I change the culture to succeed with data? Where do I start? There are so many data management practices, data quality, master data management, so on. Which data stewards should I assign to do what work and when? Everything's going to cascade from picking business initiatives and working backwards from there. Which data stewards should I assign? Well, let's start with the data domains that are necessary to succeed with the targeted business initiatives. Hey, which data should I enter into my data catalog first? Why not catalog the data that's needed to support the targeted business initiatives? Which data quality issues should I address? How about addressing the data quality issues that are going to be, that need to be resolved in order to succeed with targeted? So, this may sound a bit repetitive, but I'm telling you, this is the way to figure out how to prioritize your work. It's a way to figure out how to justify the work that you're doing to get the funding, even if funding is scarce. So here you have major business initiatives that are funded maybe in the hundreds of millions of dollars. And I'll have folks say, well, we just can't get the funding for data governance. Meanwhile, you have these hundreds of millions of dollars, maybe billions of dollars of major initiatives. Just about every one of them, if not all of them, need data for success, and it's going to need to be in a condition to serve the needs of that business initiative. That's how you get funding for data governance, even when budgeting is scarce. So again, a lot of specific activities around data governance cascades from this point, and we'll talk about that more in the rest of this program. But that's where to start. Get this right, and everything else will fall into place. So let's say, for example, you're targeting a supply chain initiative, right? And it's an end-to-end supply chain optimization. Well, the data that you're going to need, so let's talk about reusing data and also the need to integrate data from across a variety of sources. So for just for the supply chain program, when you're automatically replenishing inventory in stores and distribution centers and so on, you're going to need sales data, you're going to need retail inventory data, you're going to need order data, inventory in the warehouses and shipments and receipts and all of those things to get a complete view of your supply chain so you can optimize inventory levels. Well, it turns out that there are going to be, and this is from my own experience, that there are many other initiatives that need that same data. So first we're integrating it, okay, so it's coherent. But then think about optimizing shelf space. Think about labor planning and making sure you have the right people and the right roles at the right time and so on. Pricing optimization. There are so many different things that are going to need the same sales data, for example, okay? There's data around customer that you're going to need for a variety of purposes. And so data about the products that are going to be needed. So that's needed for all of these different programs. So you're going to find that as you align to major business initiatives, that the need to integrate data, you're not going to integrate data just because it's a good idea. You're going to integrate data because it's necessary to support the specific initiatives that you've targeted, and it's going to become obvious too across initiatives, the data commonalities that you're gonna see. So those will become quite apparent. But it all depends on supporting targeted initiatives, not prioritizing the data on its own or prioritizing data governance based on its own value. It all cascades from the business initiatives that you're targeting. So the question comes up a lot about, so how am I gonna show the value of data governance over time? What metrics? And what I've seen many times is, there will be metrics like number of attributes cataloged, things like that, or number of data quality issues resolved, or even trying to attach some business value directly to data quality issues that are resolved. And there's nothing wrong with measuring all of those things. However, the best way to measure the value of the program is to measure the contribution that the data governance program makes to one or more business initiatives. Now, in truth, there's no sort of hard and fast mathematical way to do this. It's very difficult to take the value proposition for a program like a customer experience initiative and ask, well, what is the value of the underlying data that contributes to this initiative? And what would have happened if we didn't have this data governance program in place to make sure these data quality issues? Now, you can do some things like imagine a scenario where the data quality is low and what kind of implications that has for that initiative. So there are some things you can do mathematically. But even if you just tell anecdotal stories about how the data governance program supports the initiative, how it was necessary, again, like a load-bearing wall, and very importantly, the leader of that targeted initiative would state that, would say, without this data governance program, we would not have succeeded, and here's why. So yes, you can put some quantification around it, but you also just want to be able to tell those stories. In fact, this is sometimes I'll use this as a mental test, or work with customers and ask them to think about this. What if somebody canceled the data governance program tomorrow? Who would be upset? You want to be in a position, this is what I mean by a load-bearing wall, you want to be in a position where if the data governance program is canceled tomorrow, then you have to cancel some other major funded initiative because they, you have built a relationship that they are absolutely counting on the program for the success of that program. They did not include in the scope of their initiative to make sure all elements of the data are in a condition necessary for success. They are completely relying on the data governance program to help make that happen. So that is a good test to see, have you started correctly in the program? Have you met this first test, which is what happens if they canceled the program? Is it one of those things that's more like a guest house? Instead of a load-bearing wall, you're building a guest house. Well, it's a nice thing. Everybody would like to have one, but when funding gets tight and things get difficult, it's something that can be that you don't necessarily have to have. So that's a good way to sort of do a thought exercise to see if you're on the right track. If you're not, that's the thing that needs to be addressed first before you start thinking about master data management or quality or which tools do I need and all of that.